However, there are some gotchas here. What happens, for example, if the length of the document is zero? All of a sudden, you have divide by zero.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
So we're going to have to, we would have to consider that as a special case. Also, what exactly do we mean by the size of the handle? As we said, we probably from the GUI toolkit would get some pixels, mm-hmm. Number of pixels, but we would need to translate that into something like a percentage or an integer count of things. And then there's an even more subtle situation. Let's say that we've scrolled to the end of the file.
Okay.
And we resize the window to make it bigger.
Okay.
What happens, what do we expect to see in the viewport? So one possibility is we would see exactly the same lines, but now some blank lines at the bottom.
Okay.
Okay. Another possibility is that the line that was at the bottom of the viewport before stays at the bottom of the viewport, and we see some more lines at the top.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And in fact, if you go play around with actual web browsers out there and with word processing editors and so on, you can see both of these behaviors. However, if we're designing the application, we have to make a decision about which one of those two behaviors we actually intend that the text browser to have. Okay, so this process of modeling has forced us into thinking about something which we might not have otherwise thought about, which is one of the benefits of doing the modeling. It forces you to think through subtleties of things.